This section, we are going to know a little bit more about debugging your Gradio web application. And also, Gradio has a nice feature called flagging, and we are going to look more into that. First, let's start with debugging. In the previous section at the end, you might have seen that we tried to debug. So extending that, we are going to see what kind of errors that we might face and then some debugging options that we have. The first thing that you need to make sure whenever you are building your Gradio application is that the function that you are using for your Gradio application, the number of arguments in your function should be equal to the number of elements in your inputs, and also the number of arguments or number of items that you are returning should be equal to the number of items or elements in your output. So this is the first thing, very important thing that you need to make sure that it is right. The second thing is the type of the argument. For example, here name is a text, make sure the input is text. Here, if you have an output text, again, make sure that it is an output text. So whatever the type is, make sure it is that type so that you know the types have not messed up, because you are not going to compile anything and check. So it's always good to have this validation. Like if you are creating a checklist of test cases, this is something that you should do. And let's say that you have done all these things right, and then you have built an application, but still, if you want to validate whether your application has any error, then this is how you have to debug it. And the way if you want to debug is, basically you have to enable debug is equal to true. So debug is equal to true is just a function, like an extra argument that will help you enable display error messages. If you want error messages to be displayed while the Gradio application is run, which is going to run without stopping, then you need to enable debugging, like debug is equal to true. So let me quickly give you an example and then we'll move on to the next section. So if you see this thing, for example, here we have got height and weight and filling, right? So by default, let's say if I don't have debug is equal to true, okay, I have this thing here, I'm going to give some name, right? And then I'm going to have something here. And if I submit, it worked. But let's say if I keep it like this and submit, you see an error. Now, do you know why this error is happening? No, of course you wouldn't know why this error is happening. Even though, like, probably if you're a math whiz, you would have probably predicted it by this time. But yeah, let's assume that you are an average programmer. So you don't know why the error is happening. And that's why it's important for us to enable debugging like this. And then after we do that, so it says the cell will indefinitely run like we saw before. So it's going to run all the time so that you can try a lot of different things and then, you know, have the error log in place. So now I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to put the name and then keep it zero, and then submit. So it shows error. The moment it shows error, it's going to also show the error message. And the error message here is zero division error. So float division error. So basically what has happened here is that this is a thing that you wouldn't have probably anticipated when you created this application, because now you're dividing weight by height and then height cannot be zero because you're going to get divisible by zero error. And what is the ideal solution? You can go to your code, you can change everything, you can handle the test conditions, or if you want to simply make a change, you can just come back here in the slider, you can start with one so that your user can never go to zero. So run this. And now again, most likely you are starting with one. So even if somebody submits something, there is no way that they're going to hit zero in this case. So this is again a very typical example of how do you find out an error and then fix an error using Gradio's debugging method. So if you want the debugging method to be enabled and a lot of other things. So basically the same way you debug your Python programming code. So you can debug your Gradio application in a very similar way with debug is equal to true enabled while you are launching the application. Now that is said, so the other important thing that I just talked about is flag. I just told the start of this section that flag is another very interesting case. So what is flag? The flag is a button that helps you flag any erroneous or unexpected behavior in the output. So you could be running a model and then suddenly you see something weird, you can use flag. You could have, like, let's say image segmentation model, and then you're trying to find out which images have done well, which images have not done well. So you can just click flag whenever you see the images have not done well. And you could use this for a lot of purpose. But what happens when you click flag? That's the most important question, right? Let's say you have an internal machine learning team and you have created an application and given it to them. And that team, whenever they find out something weird, some, let's say some bias, something unexpected happening in the model behavior, or even in this calculation, something weird is happening, right? So now we want to flag the team that has created this application. So what does it mean? What does the team see when we create flag here? So let's do a couple of flags, then I'll let you know. So first, there is a flag. So let's do one more thing, and then we'll say another flag. Okay, so we have flagged at this point, we have flagged two items in this case. So now what happens here is when you create flag, ideally there is a flagged folder that gets created. So I've stopped it, and then if I go back, there is a flagged folder. So when we go to the folders, let me refresh the folder, and you can see there is a flagged folder and there is a log here. Let me copy the path of this folder, come back here, and then use pandas to show you what is there. Import pandas as pd.read_csv in the path, and then you can see the instances. You can see the instances, what is the name, what are the inputs that were given, and what was the output, and these are flagged. So this is to help the machine learning team or ML ops team, whatever the team that is going to look into the model issues, to check what are the items that are flagged by the users or internal testing or whatever that is, right? So whenever you flag something, there is a new entry that is made here, and that entry is used in the future to evaluate the model or the performance of the application. So right now what you saw is an application that just had text. So now what happens when you have images? What happens when you have images, right? For example, we had an application like this. What happens when you have an image like this, when you have an application that has images? Both the input and output images get stored. Unlike this, where you have text, where you have everything in tabular data only, and you didn't have anything else, right? So if you go to the folder, you wouldn't see anything else other than .csv. But when you have images, the actual images or any other media type for that matter, the actual media content itself is stored inside that folder, making it easier for you to evaluate what has gone wrong. This is a very important aspect. Again, when you are going to use Gradio for iterating your machine learning model or improving your machine learning model, this is quite important and useful to use. And again, a lot of people who build Gradio might not be very aware of this thing, because you know, it just exists there. But yeah, efficiently using flag can improve your machine learning model, can help you identify there is a bias. Like for example, let's say you've put together a machine learning model, and then you've created a Gradio web application, you have published it on Hugging Face Spaces or somewhere. You can explicitly tell your users, saying that if you find anything interesting, weird, then please go ahead and click flag, because that will help us improve the model, eliminate the biases, or you know, be more robust. So you can tell this explicitly in the description. Like you have a description, right? Like you can write a description here like this, and then flag if you find any erroneous output. Okay, so I can run this, and then I can, let me disable it, and then it can run. When it runs, it will describe, so flag if you find any erroneous output. So having this message very clearly as part of the application could help people understand that when they see something wrong, they have to flag, and that comes to you as a very well structured data which you can use in the future to fix your machine learning model or do anything that you want to do with the data. So one aspect of debugging in Gradio is actually, you know, using the debug is equal to true. But I'm also including this in this section because I believe that if your machine learning model doesn't work well, if your machine learning model is doing something semantically wrong, not syntactically, but semantically wrong, only the user who is actually seeing the output can tell you that thing, and that human intervention could be made, the flag could be raised using this flag button, and that could be extremely useful in a lot of different cases. One thing that you would want to note when you're talking about flag is, so right now the flag content is in the actual folder, like the current folder, but if you want it to be in a different folder, then you have a flagging directory. So you can have a separate directory, you can specify a separate flagging directory, and that will probably enable you to have this flagging, like flagged content, in a different directory altogether if you want it to be in a different directory. But otherwise, everything is good here. Flagging is extremely helpful. This is how you do debugging, and these are some things that you should pay more attention to. And in the next section, we will learn some quirks and nuances about Gradio application.